what's going on? Ryan here, SetSpaceTriathlon.com. We are going to be diving into Ironman California. At the time of this recording, it is October 20th. The race is on, you can see it on the screen, October 24th. Got my screen over here for software running the streaming, and then got a screen over here for comments, and I got my dog licking my legs. So hopefully there's no distractions and nobody walking through or anything like that. If there is, I apologize. But anyway, we're going to jump right into it. I'm in California. I want to talk about athlete guide. So I've gone through the swim, the bike, the run, the weather, a few other things highlighted in there, and talk about the athlete guide, and hopefully get into the some information where I think the best place for spectators would be. So if you got any comments, put them on the comments. Any questions or anything like that, I'll have that up live while I'm doing this little discussion. And it's pretty much kind of similar for all races. I'm not doing Ironman California, but I have a couple athletes that are, and I've been doing plans for a couple athletes. So I do the course review, course recon, all that kind of stuff. So I kind of made videos so everybody has this information out there. So hopefully it helps you guys too. So if you go to Ironman California's main website, you go down to athletes, go on athlete guide, and then click on the PDF, and it brings up your 56-page athlete guide. So I'm not going to really dive into too depth on some of this stuff, but I just kind of want to hit the highlights to make sure you guys are aware of this. And I kind of go over what pages I print. So I always print the first page because it's kind of nice and, you know, kind of artistic. So I print this off, print off the pages that I need only because I don't like to waste my paper. I don't like to waste my ink. Stapled together, and I take this with me the whole time. It's with me when I'm flying someplace, riding someplace, whatever. I've got it with me all the time so I can reference. I have to fumble with my phone if I don't have a reception or anything. I know where things are at and what's going on. So, if you want to learn a little bit about the race director, you can put that page off. Event schedule, this is very important. Now in the athlete information area, they have the event schedule separate out separately, but it's in the athlete guide too, so print out. So the main things to know is the times of events. The race is on Sunday, October 24th. You cannot check in on the Saturday. So athlete check-in must be done either Thursday or Friday, because on Saturday there is no athlete check-in. There's bike check-in only and gear bag drop. And then they have some athlete briefings. So Thursday and Friday, and it's typical for most Ironman races, those are your check-in days, so make sure you know where you're going. Capitol Mall and 9th Street. I go to Google Maps. I got Google Maps on my phone. I go through and I mark these. I'll highlight them. I'll do a save. So this is the Capitol Mall on 9th Street. So this is where Ironman Village and check-in is going to happen. So I definitely zoom in there, check out for any parking or anything like that, so you know you have a place to park, because this looks like it's going to be a pretty, you know, busy little area. Turn on the map here. Watching paint dry. So as you can see, this is probably going to be a busy area and probably a hard place to find parking. So I would definitely do a little bit of stalking online to find out where some parking is, to make sure that you can park in the right place. So when you show up, if you're driving in, you can go straight there, get checked in, or if you're staying somewhere, you know, maybe it's, you know, if you're staying in NBC Suites or something like that, maybe it's within walking distance. So something to, you know, Sheraton Grand, maybe it's some place that you can walk to. So just make sure the athlete guide, the event schedule has the addresses, locations for everything, and when it's going on, where everything's going to be at. So if you need anything in Ironman Village, you need to buy anything, Ironman Store, athlete check-in, athlete briefing times, and where those are at. Typically, they're doing these also. They're recording and posting online. For events I go to, I've actually been posting in the Facebook groups, but I digress. But so get there, plan out your trip, plan out. You know, I'm recording this on a Wednesday. Check-in doesn't start until Thursday, so get the event schedule, diagram out where you're going to be, when you're going to be. You should have already signed up for a check-in time slot. Make sure you have that QR code. They won't let you in without it, and they'll make you sit there and wait, and then they'll send over the athlete help if you can't find your QR code, so make sure you have that for check-in. So Thursday is athlete check-in, Ironman Store. I've been telling everybody this. I would highly recommend getting there, you know, the 3 days before the race, the first day of check-in, to get the Ironman Store, because, you know, things like this, like 70.3 Memphis, you want a hat, you had to get it pretty much the morning of, or the first few hours of check-in for the first day, because after that they were gone. So if you find a hat you like, you find jerseys you like, shirts you like, anything like that, get it, because everybody's been starved for races for a year and a half. So So they're coming in hot and they're buying up all the stuff. So get in the Ironman Village, buy what you want, and pay for it, because don't be counting on to be there later and be discounted after the end of the race, because it's not going to be there if it's the good stuff. So that's going to be my plug for that. If you have any problems with your bike, I would definitely get that checked out at the Play Tri store. They're going to be busy, so get your bike out, unpack it, put it all together, make sure it works. And if you got problems, take it to the Play Tri store as fast as possible, because they're going to fill it too. So Friday's kind of the same thing going on. Athlete briefings, and they're having a welcoming ceremony, which is a little bit different. Most races have been doing that type of stuff. So, you know, if you want to go, Sacramento River Cats Baseball Stadium. That's the 400 ballpark drive, it looks like. So it's kind of across the river from checking and everything. So if you want to do a welcoming ceremony, I would imagine they're going to have it in the stadium so you can sit in the stands or something like that. Kind of keep social distancing and all that kind of stuff. And we're still kind of considering the pandemic situation, especially out in California. They're a little bit more conservative with their approach. So just make sure you keep that in mind. So welcoming ceremony. They're doing the Iron Kids Fun Run at Ironman Village, so Capitol Mall. So again, if you're going to do that, 9 a.m., make sure you have parking planned out, because you don't want to be in a hurry and not being able to find parking spots. And then 9 a.m. passes and the kid's upset they didn't get to do the fun run. So Saturday, like I said, there's no check-in. Ironman store is open. Ironman Village is open. Mandatory bike check-in from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Make sure you're reading where this stuff is at. Don't show up to Ironman Village looking to check in your bike and then realize it's at the River Cats Baseball Stadium, because you're getting there at 3:30 and you're like, oh crud, I gotta drive over to the River Cats. You get there past 4 o'clock, you may be in a pinch. So just make sure you're paying attention to where all these locations are at, and the event schedule has it. Sunday, you drop your personal needs bike and run bag at the Riverfront Street near Ballpark Drive. Transition opens at the River Cats Baseball Stadium, so you're not going to Ironman Village, you're not going to check-in. Spectator and athlete buses, notice face mask requirement on the shuttle bus, so be prepared. Ironman's giving a face mask with the kind of goodie bag, so you should have one. Pro Men start, so go Lionel Sanders. He posted he's doing this race in 2021, so 6:40 a.m. Pro Men start at the Township Park, so make sure you know where this stuff is at. Especially if people are going to come drive over here and try to find you at the swim start. So make sure that you have all the stuff mapped out. Then shuttle bus back to T1, so your spectators can ride the shuttle buses back to T1, it looks like. Ironman Village, so volunteer check-in, all that kind of stuff. Ironman stores open, athlete and spectator shuttle bus. So to and from Sacramento River Cats Baseball Stadium and Ironman Village. So they will have a bus going from Baseball Stadium to the finish line and Ironman Village area. So that is probably the same bus you'll be using as athletes go to get back to your stuff, because everything's going to be back at the main transition area here at the River Cats Baseball Stadium. So just count on that. It's all going to be there. Make sure you're prepared to ride that bus back. You'll circle approximately 10 to 15 minutes, so you don't have to wait too long. Finish line is at 10th Street, post-race athlete food. Morning clothes bag pickup is at the finish line secure zone. So here's one little the nuance, morning clothes bag. So if you want stuff to change into before you ride the bus, go back to transition and get your stuff. You can get your, make sure you pick up your morning clothes bag at the finish line. Then you're getting your bike, your gear bags at bike gear checkout at the River Cats Baseball Stadium. Notice you do not get your special needs bags back. Once they're on the course, if you use them, you don't use them, they're trash. So you're getting your T1 bag, your T2 bag, and your morning clothes bag, and your bike. So make sure you get all that stuff before you leave. Like I said, make sure you get the morning clothes bag at the finish line. Don't go back to the baseball stadium and be like, oh, where's my morning clothes bag? Oh, it's back over at the finish line. I have to ride the bus back. Oh, I don't get it. Don't do that. Make sure you read the event schedule. Make sure you draw out. You know, I write down schedules for everything. I have my little notebook. Write it down where you're going to be. You're going to be delirious. You're going to be tired. Make sure you have something you can reference what you're supposed to be doing and when and where. And then Monday, Ironman Store, Ironman Village, additional biking gear checkout. So if you did miss it on race day, they're giving you an opportunity to pick it up on Monday. Play Tri, Triathlon Store, Tech Center. So I think some people can break down your bike and they can check it out and bring in all that kind of stuff. Breakfast at 9 a.m. on Monday. And then, pardon me, my phone is buzzing. Let's make sure. An award ceremony, 2022 Ironman World Championship slots. They have been adding extra slots because they've changed the way the Ironman World Championships. They're doing the 21 version in May of 22 in St. George, and then the 22 race in Hawaii in October. So with all that shuffling, they're opening up more spots for the World Championships. So if you want them, you have to be there in person. Usually they've been adding some post-race, and then people get notification later. But if you want to race the World Championship and you qualify, you need to show up at 9 a.m. to get your spot and roll down and awards and stuff. Check-in information. So this is all the check-in information. Ironman Village, they got the address. Let's see if I don't know. Close the PDF. So if we look, I've kind of found this a problem before. So notice I clicked the live link in the PDF. Capitol Mall, 9th Street, Sacramento, California. For whatever reason, it's taking you to the wrong place. So make sure you're doing your Google Capitol Mall, 9th Street. Make sure you're doing your Google properly and make sure you're finding your address. What to bring? QR code registration. Make sure you bring that or else they're not going to let you check in, and it's going to be a process and it's going to be a pain in the butt. So check-in screening. Just be prepared for all the COVID information you're going to have to go through. Check-in steps, emergency contact, all those good stuff. So print this page out. It's good to have. This is the questions that they'll be asking you, so you can read through that. So you can't say, well, I've never seen this. And they're going to say, did you read the athlete guide? And you're going to say, well, I thought I did. And if you didn't read this page, you didn't read it. So pages like this, I don't print the advertisements. I mean, wonderful. You know, they got to make their money with the advertisements and stuff, but I don't print them out. I don't waste my pages because this PDF is 56 pages long. Pre-race info. They got transition. They got village, swim start, practice swim area. So practice swim area. So there you go. If you want to do a practice swim, they've got an area for you. So make sure you know where that is and maybe plan for that. You know, maybe you check in on Thursday or Friday and do a practice swim. Let's see if they got a time. Mandatory bike check-in, athlete briefing, village information, personal safety, morning clothes bag, special needs bag. So we'll read through. We'll see if they have any information on practice swims. Because right here, I don't see any. Let's see if it was on the athlete schedule. So I know this is kind of boring, but this is the process I go through. Athlete check-in, fun run, briefing, transition. I don't see anything scheduled on practice, so I'm going to see if that's in later in here. So gear bag information, I print this page off, especially if you're a newbie. Kind of tells you all the information there. Race day info, this tells you transition opens, all the shuttle information, body markings, all good stuff. No body markings for this year, I print that page. Race day info, cutoffs, if that's a key important factor to you, there you go. Wetsuit optional, race conditions, I'm going to venture a guess that there's going to be wetsuit legal. There could be some wild outside chance that it's optional, but my money's on wetsuit legal. Don't print that page. Post-race info, so if you want all the information, athlete food, celebration day, finisher shirt exchange, volunteers, race photography, lost and found, I print this page just to have it. Again, like I said, I print all these pages off. I don't sit here and read it the first time through. I'll print them all off, and I'll have them with me. And then as I'm traveling and I've got time, I'll look through pages. You know, sometimes when you've got some downtime, you don't want to be sitting there with all this nervous energy, so I just go through and I just read the athlete guide. If you think you're going to qualify for the World Championships, this is your information. Application process, they've got maps, swim course information, swim start. I kind of print these off. It's kind of the same for every race. It's nothing crazy on these. Usually, don't print that page. Another map, I print off a bike course, back turn directions, just in case you want to go through and drive the course, you have the information. Whopping 700 feet of gain on a 12-mile bike course. That's awesome. Advertisement would not print off. Bike course position rules. Maybe print that off just so you're kind of aware. They will give you cards and penalty time for drafting, for littering, all kinds of good stuff. So make sure that you're paying attention to the rules. So print these off. Read the bike course rules. Would not print that off. Cycle Smart. Print that off just so you have it. Don't print off the advertisement. Bike Store Tech, I print this information off and have it. You never know when you're going to get there and your bike shifting is off, a brake is stuck, you need a brake pad, who knows what. Print this off and have it with you at all times. When I print that off, wheel rental, if you're going to do it, they're on site. Here's the information for that. here you go, is the run course. I put out that map, knowing like the back of your hand, a whopping 300 feet over 26.2 miles. Not bad. Run course information, so make sure that you printed this off and know it. Would not print, would not print. Overall rules, I print those off and read them. Sometimes there's a little different nuances for each race and stuff, and different things going on, so make sure you read that and don't get pinched for some obscure rule that you didn't know about. Physically challenged, if you're in that division, I print that off. So violations, I definitely print this off and know what the violations mean, so you're not caught out there and be like, oh, crud, they caught me, what do I do? It's your job to know that. So medical policy, you don't need medical until you need medical. So I definitely read this off and know the information there. Advertisement. So as you can see, there's lots of pages of advertisements. So if you just hit print, you'd be wasting a lot of paper, a lot of ink, and be really thick and hard to travel with. All rule athlete information, print this off if you think you can qualify for all the athlete status. Frequently asked questions, bid list, age groups, tri club, medical support, timing, slot allocation, and I'm still kind of keeping an eye out if there's anything for practice wins, advertisements, checklist. I've put out several, so if you want that, put it in the comments, and I'd be glad to give that to you. But they had their own checklist, you can put that out too, so advertisement. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3, last three pages of advertisement. So we do have a question. I'm confused, I'm not sure why I thought this was a local to Sacramento and official. I don't know. So, I am not a race director, but I am an Ironman certified coach. I do sit on calls that they have with the coaches, the Ironman University. The coaches, they're officially Ironman employees, that, and sometimes we have the race directors that are on there as well that we ask questions of. So, I do have a little bit more information than the typical athlete that maybe throws up a Facebook page or something. So, no, this is not technically a Ironman ran by a company, the company Ironman page, but it is affiliated because I am an Ironman certified coach. So I'm using this Facebook group and helping share the information that I review and do for my coaches, for my plans. I've got Ironman California plans and Training Peaks and Final Surge, working with Ironman University to put out those training plans through Final Surge and all that kind of stuff. So while no, this is not an official ran by Ironman. I am, like I said, an Ironman certified coach, so I do these little informational sessions just because I've done the training through Ironman. Like I said, I've been on a monthly call, sometimes every other week, that we do with the actual coaching group in Ironman. So we stay abreast of the information more so than maybe the general public could get. But I digress. We go back to the athlete guide. So we're looking through. So I just kind of, like I said, it's kind of a 10,000 foot view of the athlete guide. So we go through and just make sure that you're aware it's there, it's out there, it's got, and answers probably like 99% of your questions. Like I said, I go through, I find out the locations of stuff, I find the timing and stuff, I print out the pages that are pertinent to you. It is 56 pages long. I would just hit print and then print it all off and staple it together and carry it around everywhere. There's a lot of advertisements. I'd hate for you to waste your paper and ink because personally I don't like doing that either. But I just went through and kind of hit the pages. I might do a video later. We're just talking about specifically the event schedule and stuff, but I kind of hit that in a little bit in depth because that's probably one of the most important things, is making sure you get the event schedule out of here. It's got the location, so make sure you know it. I didn't see any other questions or anything. So if you get through and you watch this video later, give it a like on Facebook. If you see it on YouTube, give it a like, give me a subscribe, hit the notification button for future videos, especially about Ironman California and everything. I'm going to make my information about the race a little bit more robust about training and stuff and getting ready for the race in 2022. Hitting this information is pertinent for the race in 2021 as it's coming up this weekend. So if you have any questions, put them in the comments. I always like to go back and revamp or add information where I can to make sure this is helping you guys out as much as possible. So with that, good luck on paper. You've done all the work. Good luck on race day, and we'll see you all at the finish line.